Good afternoon. I'm Olivia Daskari, and I'm going to talk to you about hybrid experimentation for water delivery projects. Actually, I will present you an intercontinental hybrid simulation experiment that we did for the purposes of science assessment of a real three-span reinforced concrete bridge. But first of all, what is hybrid simulation? Hybrid simulation is a cost-effective alternative for dynamic testing of structures, which combines physical testing with numerical simulation. So, the concept is the following. We have a structure, in our case, a bridge. We have to divide the structure into subcomponents, into substructures, let's say into three components, the two piers and the deck of the bridge. The components with the most critical behavior are experimentally tested in the laboratory, while the components that their behavior is more predictable, such as the behavior of the deck, we expect that the deck will remain in the elastic range, and these components are numerically analyzed in computer stations. So, a hybrid test can be conducted in a single laboratory, and in that case, we are talking about a local test, but the nature of hybrid simulation allows the components to be geographically distributed among sites across a computer network. And in that case, we are talking about geographically distributed tests. Within this framework, we understand that there is no need for a unique experimental facility, and also there is no need for physical proximity of the multiple experimental and numerical components. So these components, experimental or numerical, can be located anywhere in the world. The flowchart of a hybrid test is probably the following. From a seismic scenario, we obtain a seismic input. Then we have to solve the equation of motion using a numerical integration scheme. Then we apply target displacements through a control system to the physically tested substructures. We measure the forces, and we proceed to the next time step. In order to perform all this, we need to establish connection between the numerical and the experimental models, and also to solve the equation of motion. To this end, several software packages are available, and the most popular of them are UISymCore, which was developed in University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign by Professor Sam Huon, and OpenFresco, which was developed in UC Berkeley. This concept of hybrid simulation has been widely used in Europe and in the United States. For instance, in the United States, this multi-site simulation is supported by NISHUB, which is a network for earthquake engineering simulation, and NIST runs a number of experimental facilities located at universities across the United States. In Europe, we have developed a grid-based network of advanced laboratories, and it's called similarly UK NIST, and it consists of laboratories at the University of Bristol, at Oxford University, and at the University of Cambridge. Moreover, there is also a consortium of 23 laboratories and industrial beneficiaries, which was developed in the framework of a research program called CIRIS. And this program was coordinated by Professor Michael Fardis from University of Patras. Despite the big number of hybrid tests that were executed in Europe and the United States, the number of transatlantic hybrid experimentation efforts is rather limited. An indicative case is the hybrid test that was conducted between University of Kassel and UC Berkeley. In this case, the experimental component was a friction device, which was physically tested at University of Kassel, while all the computations were conducted in UC Berkeley. Some other intercontinental tests at the component level have been performed between University of Kassel and South Korea or among University of Kassel, Oxford University and Taiwan, and at the sister level between University at Buffalo and Kyoto University. In our case, we run a research project which is funded by European Union, and it is called Exchange SSI. Exchange SSI means Experimental and Computational Hybrid Assessment Network for Ground Motion Excited Soil Structure Interacting Systems. In this project, there are six partners that participate. Aristotle University of Thessaloniki, University of Patras from Greece, and University of Sanyo from Italy, University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign from the United States, University of Toronto from Canada, and Geodynamic and Structure from France. The scope of this project is to investigate the feasibility of implementing tools and procedures that are not tailored to the existing equipment in Europe or Greece, to investigate the effect of remote host distance on the feasibility of executing hybrid testing among long separated sites, to run the first hybrid test in Greece, and finally to demonstrate the repeatability and robustness of intercontinental hybrid testing for the case of a real bridge. So in our case, we studied a real three-span reinforced concrete bridge, which is part of Egnatia Highway. Egnatia Highway is a natural laboratory for earthquake engineering research, and it was constructed along the ancient Roman path of Egnatia. The total length of the highway is about 680 kilometers, and it consists of 490 bridges and overpasses, and the total length of the bridge is about 42 kilometers. The maximum bridge length is about 1.1 kilometer, and the maximum pier height is about 90 meters. Here are some indicative bridges. Some of them you visited yesterday during your trip. This is Grevenyotikos Bridge, G4 Bridge and Polymelos Veria Bridge, and Metsovitikos Bridge, a day and a night view. Apart from the straight bridges, there are also some curved bridges, and I will show you the most impressive one. It is Kristallopigi Bridge, and it is the largest curved bridge in Greece. The total length is about 850 kilometers for the left branch and 640 kilometers for the right branch. The deck is a continuous box-shaped pre-stressed concrete section. The curvature radius is equal to 450 meters, and the number of spans is 10. And the maximum pier height is about 30 meters. In our case, for the purposes of the hybrid test, we examined a simple bridge. It is an overpass with a total length of 99 meters. The inner span is 45 meters long, and the two outer span has a length of 27 meters. The piers are monolithically connected to the deck, and the deck is supported on C-type abutments with two elastomeric bearings at each end. The deck of the bridge is a concrete box girder section with a width which is equal to 10 meters, and the piers are solid circular sections with a diameter equal to 2 meters. As I mentioned before, the first step in hybrid simulation is to partition the structure into subcomponents. In our case, the structure, the bridge, was divided into five components: the deck, the right and the left pier, and the right and the left bearing. From these components, the left bearing was physically tested at the University of Patras by Professor Boussias and his team, while the other modules were numerically analyzed in computer stations. These computers were located in Toronto, in Urbana-Champaign, in Italy and in Greece. Before proceeding to the hybrid simulation test, we had to perform a number of preparatory works. First of all, we have to be sure that the substructured model yields similar results to those of the full model. For this scope, the bridge was modeled as a whole in OpenSys, and then it was substructured into submodels, into substructures, and we compare the results of these two purely numerical analyses. We see the four displacement relationship for the left bearing, and we see that multi-platform analysis yields similar results to those of the full model. Then we had to check if the time analysis increases if we add another partner in the simulation analysis. So we ran five different multi-platform analyses. The first one was between the first one is a local analysis in Aristotle University Thessaloniki. The second run we added a partner from Patras. The third one a partner from Italy, then from the University of Toronto, and then UIUC. And we see that analysis time increases when a module runs in the United States or in Canada. For a 100 Mbps network, more than 50% of the latency can be attributed to crossing the Atlantic. And 7 to 10 hops and approximately 6 milliseconds are required to reach the last European hop, while more than 70 milliseconds are spent before connecting to the first transatlantic hop in Toronto. Then we had to find the optimal geographic distribution of the modules. So the modules were assigned to all the partners and purely numerical multi-platform simulations were performed. And we found that a different partner series affects the execution time by 50%. These hybrid simulations, purely numerical simulations, multi-platform simulations, were conducted in starting at different times during the day, and we found that the most favorable time for conducting the intercontinental multi-platform simulation is between 2 and 4 a.m. and 12 and 14 p.m. Greek time. Essentially, this corresponds to off-peak networking times for the American partners. And we also found that a different time window affects execution time by 30%. From the breakdown of the total analysis time to the individual sources of delay, we can see that networking time consumes 70% of the overall analysis, that module coordination and handling consumes 15% of the overall analysis, and finite element analysis consumes less than 15% of overall analysis. Of course, it depends on the complexity of the model, on the degrees of freedom, on the intensity level, and the non-linearity of the model. A second group of preparatory work was performed in the University of Patras, and they studied the effect of strain rate on the bearings response. And they executed a number of tests on single bearings and then a number of hybrid simulation tests at the local level. An important issue that they had to deal with was related was that they had to find a way to connect the controller with the simulation software with Simple. So they followed two different approaches. The first one is tailored to the specific hardware-software pair available at home lab and is completely software-based. A MATLAB module is implemented running outside the existing digital controller and which can directly modify certain values in the memory blocks of the controller in the database. The MATLAB module uses TCP/IP protocol communication over the internet to receive new target values from the integration algorithm and the internal laboratory network to write these reference values to the memory block. The second approach employs a use of additional hardware together with software. It is based on the fact that although many labs operate old versions of controllers, not providing any network communication capabilities, most of them can accept external input in analog form. Thus, target displacements sent out by a remote site in which Simcon is running are received by a purpose-built software, Nikon, under the land use environment. The two different approaches were compared, and this is the force displacement relationship for the experimental module for the bearing, and the comparison of force displacement loops is we can see that there is a very good agreement between the two different approaches. Then a hybrid simulation test was executed between University of Patras and Aristotle University of Thessaloniki. The physically tested component, the bearing, was tested in University of Patras, while all the computations were executed in Aristotle University of Thessaloniki. And we used our server, H Cooper, which is, let's say, a supercomputer that is available in our laboratory. And then we executed the intercontinental hybrid simulation test between all the partners, between Greece, Italy, Canada, and United States. And this is the first hybrid test that was ever done in Greece. Here we see the response of the four modules, of the four numerical modules, and the bearing that was physically tested in the University of Patras in the laboratory. And finally, we compare the results of this hybrid simulation test. The first one that was executed locally at the University of Patras, the second, the red line, was executed between University of Patras and Aristotle University of Thessaloniki, and the green line is the intercontinental hybrid simulation test between Greece, Italy, Canada, and United States. And we can see that the results are in a very good agreement. We see the four displacement loops for the tested bearing. We also checked the task execution time required to complete one integration step when solving the equation of motion. And we see that the major source of delay is the physical testing of the bearing, the red line. The red line is the fourth module, the bearing that was physically tested at the University of Patras. And we also see that network times reduced as much as possible, and the expanded time scale was about 100 to 200 times. So the conclusions of this hybrid experiment is that it is indeed feasible to implement tools and procedures that are not tailored to the existing equipment in Europe after appropriate hardware and software adaptation at the local host. The first hybrid test in Greece was run successfully between two sites. An intercontinental experiment between five sites was performed successfully. Remote hosts can be introduced depending on the time expansion tolerance of rate-sensitive devices. Network latency is a critical factor that currently can only be reduced at a certain degree. One-to-one time scale real-time hybrid simulation was not currently feasible between Greece and North America. And finally, the feasibility depends on improved real-time hybrid simulation algorithms and reduced network latency. A list of the work published during this project. And of course, I would like to say that this is a joint work between our university and University of Patras and University of Sanyo, University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign and University of Toronto. And I would like to thank all our partners, especially the coordinator, Professor Sextus. Thank you very much. Any questions? I think that we can proceed. Ah, okay.
This hybrid method is to take quick results from some damage that may have happened very recently, or
what do you mean by quick results?
Um, the cooperation between the universities leads to some quicker results or not?
If I understand your question, you mean why to do a hybrid simulation test?
Yes.
And not something else.
Yeah.
You have to consider factors that are related to the space limitations at the labs, or the capacity of the equipment at the labs, and maybe scaling issues or the high operational cost that of the facilities. So the advantages of hybrid simulation test is that you can take advantage of the capabilities of different laboratories in order to conduct a test which is as realistic as if you do a conventional approach.
And also creating the database of data that may be useful for future
yes.
tests.
Mm-hmm.
As I understand now that the idea is that some laboratory in some way carry out some tests and the data is streamed real time to another place to analyze on a spot at the same time.
Yes.
But this can be done but not in real time. This can be done.
There are algorithms, there are algorithms which are available that you can do a test, that you can perform a test, to execute a test on real time. It depends on the problem that you study. If you have a problem like the one that we had, which the experimental component was a bearing, in this case, the effect of stress drain effect are very important. So it's hard to do exactly a real time simulation. But there are some other projects. For example, if you study, let's say, a peer, if the experimental component is a peer, so in that case you can do, you can execute this test in a more realistic way. But of course, there are some algorithms that help and work in, on a real-time simulation.
Yes, but the point is it useful to make it real-time so we can perform the test and after we finish, we send all the data to whatever any place in the world and then make the analysis. What is the importance to make it real time? Is there a need for this?
Of course there is a need for this. Because as I told before, there isn't one laboratory in that you can do everything on this. So you can combine the equipment that is available on different laboratories in that case with the hybrid simulation test.
So maybe many tests for similar components in different places are controlled?
Yes. So you can combine the capabilities of different laboratories at the same time. You can run physical tests on different laboratories for the same experiment and run one experiment.
Okay.